So, I've kind of been lying to you. Like, not intentionally, I didn't mean to, but I've kind of been leading you on. And we need to talk about it. I've talked about it a little bit with my patrons, but the thing is, there's a lot of stuff that I've told you I was gonna tell you. There are a lot of things I've teased, a lot of things I've said, like this is what I'm thinking about, we'll talk about it later, or like, oh, look at the secret project, number one, or secret project. Number two, I've just been scared to start living. I feel like I have this obligation to you as an audience member, as somebody who watches me, to keep you up to date. Like, I've made this deal, this pact that's unspoken, but to share honestly and openly what's going on in my life. There are certain things I'm not gonna tell you because I don't need to, it's not safe, it's not right, whatever. But there's a lot that I have told you I'm going to tell you. And then to not tell you is, I mean, it's shitty to put it in a word, but it's also, it's basically just kind of stringing you along. And I didn't mean to do it, but I was doing it for a while. And I think it's just kind of robbed us of something. And I want to get that back. Let me try to explain. You see, the thing is, there's life. And then there's the thing that you want your life to amount to, or many things you want your life to amount to, or where you want to end up, who you want to end up with, what it is that you want to accomplish. And in the process of working towards those things, kind of waiting for life to start once you have them, you forget to realize life already start, like life, it's going. It's ongoing. It started a while ago, when before you even technically remember, and you can't wait around for it to start because it's already moving. It's going. I don't know if that affects you at all. I don't know if you're waiting to start living. In many ways, it could be argued that I have definitely started living. I have quite a lot going on, and yet all these stories that I've been wanting to tell you, I've been waiting for something to happen in order to tell you. Like, I've been waiting for the weight loss to be over before I tell you about it. And I've been waiting for the app to be further along before I tell you about it. And I've been waiting for my French citizenship to be underway before I talk about it. And ultimately, that's just because I'm afraid. It turns out, I guess I'm afraid of failing in public as much as anything, which is an ongoing thing that I need to stop. I'm doing better about. But it turns out it's because I'm afraid. I'm afraid that I'll fail at losing the weight along the way, or that the app will fall apart before I ever get a chance to really share with you, or that it'll suck and that you won't like it, or that, like, I'll be single for the rest of my life and we won't talk about dating in Paris, or, you know, what it's like to whatever, blah, 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 instead of just, like, diving in and sharing what's going on as it's going on. And so in the end, I end up robbing you and me of a great conversation, but also just, like, enjoying life right now.
So we're heading to Abila. This is like the fourth time I've tried to take this because I actually don't know what we're walking into. Basically, we're going to support our friend Lindsay, who's hosting a roundtable about food at a new restaurant. It's like a concept store. Prashant knows what's going on better than I do, but we're kind of just walking in blind and hoping that there's going to be coffee. And that's kind of one of those things that, like, I've been wanting to get back to on the lighter side, you know, is exploring new places and taking back to classics, which we'll do a classic after that. And but also, it's been a lack. I probably shouldn't be doing this on the metro. Everybody's so quiet this morning.
That was perfect. Bonjour, on est là. That's all I wanted. So thing number one, the thing that I'm most excited about, that I've been so excited about for years, that I've been wanting to talk about more and more, has to do with food, which is what this whole thing is, and helping you to find good food, new places, interesting things, and that is the app, which we've been developing for a long, I've been working on this for a long time now. The iteration, the version that I had in mind, we've had to walk away from for the time being, simplify it, bring it down. But if you could think of, like, Jay's Guide, would it be great as a PDF, or would it be great as an interactive, geo-localized experience when I'm in Paris?
how do I help you find stuff while you're here without scrolling through, you know, a book? Not to disparage my guide, it's very popular. Overwhelmingly positive feedback in the surveys we've done recently. Like, people really like my guide. It's a lot of plug. Do buy it if you're coming to Paris anytime soon and you want all my recommendations and a whole lot of information on how to travel here. But how do we make that experience better for you? And why have I not been talking to you about it? I mean, really, because I'm scared it won't work. That's probably why.
You know, you're a good moderator, right?
Oh, thanks. This is a live video. You love to do the close-ups where you're going to
see,
like,
so
all
good.
My sweat.
You look so good. Well, why are you sweating? Yeah, what's up here? There's
like,
lots of pressure. Schmitz. Another thing that I haven't been talking about is the weight loss journey. It's one of my biggest insecurities is how I look, especially like the torso region more than anything. It has been for most of my life. It's not really anymore. It's gone away slowly, but it's a story that I haven't shared and I should have shared because I started the weight loss journey, like this most recent one, last October when I was burned out and didn't want to be on camera and then didn't just want to get into it. And then I started filming later as the progress started showing up. Part of that was a fear of sharing the insecurities. Part of that was just like a fear that I wouldn't be able to follow through because it is really hard. Losing weight's really hard. And it's actually a video I'm working on right now that I'm making this video instead today because it's still really hard to make that video. But I want to share it because I think it's important. It's an important part of my health, part of my life. It's big decisions that I've made and a lot of effort that I've put it in. And I'm not doing us any favors by not talking about it. And you know, here we are coming to a brunch place after Lindsay's roundtable there, or panel discussion. It's a good, probably should talk about the whole weight loss thing. We'll talk, that video is coming out real soon. If you want to know more about like all of this as well, Garage Monologues, my podcast, I went into detail about a lot of this in an episode, the most recent episode to come out, which is available to my members, my patrons, but will be available in another 6 months if you're not a patron. So thanks to today's patron producer, Lane Karras, and all my patrons for making all of this possible. And they already have access to that Garage Monologue, that most recent episode. If you'd like to listen to it, jump on over on Patreon. You'll get a link to the members only podcast feed, and you'll be able to, you know, get caught up. And you've got a good 6 months worth of podcasts to listen to that won't be public for, you know, until the next season is ready. You get it. I'm hungry, let's go. If you remember the game, like back in the day, we had the scavenger hunt across Paris, and that was actually an early attempt, like an analog version of trying to figure out how to build a recommendation engine that was fun and interactive and that you would get credit for participating in. And I never really talked about where that was going and why, because like I wanted to figure it out. I was kind of being protective and secretive of the idea. And you know, at the end of the day, you just lose yourself in kind of a faux sense of secrecy, which is why we call that one secret project number two. Hey, Cooper. And you know, here you go. It makes you feel any more stressed out? It's my wallet that's propping the lens up. Well, speaking of not stress, but so Kate, we talked a little bit about how the newsletter's coming back, but it's coming back like this month?
This week, hopefully.
Oh my gosh, that's really
cool. Well, let's not say that yet.
It's coming back really soon. It's coming back really soon. So I'll put a link below if you've never subscribed to my newsletter before. We'll be talking about, you know, more good stuff in there as well. But yeah, haven't talked about how Kate's coming back really, how Emily's coming on board, how the cops just... I'm really good at picking locations to talk on camera with good sound.
Live in Paris.
There's a lot going on. I think that's actually, hold on a second. I think that's actually one of the fears in a way is that I'm gonna run out of stuff to talk about, you know? Like at some point, pick up my wallet before I forget that that's on the ground. At some point, I feel like anybody that's making content for a living has that fear where they're like, I'm gonna run out of stuff to say, things to talk about, what's going on, but that I have to trust, and this is true, that there's an endless amount of stuff to talk about. Life is just endlessly interesting. My life happens to be fairly interesting as it is, and then, you know, you can tell so many stories as you go. I need to just not worry about that and dive in and tell the stories as they're happening, because once they've already happened, they're behind you. And I'm so sorry that I've left you out on so many things that have been going on because of these fears. One of the other arenas that I'm, you know, don't talk about that much, my relationships, romantically, doesn't mean I can't talk about dating, but it does tie in directly to what I believe is kind of the root beyond the fear of these problems, which is waiting for something to happen before you start living. We're also reading Company of One as a team right now, which is very helpful. It's a good book. I'd say if you're a business owner, entrepreneur, or self-starter, or if you work in a business where you need to be a self-starter, it's helpful for the mindset. Hopefully you like it.
I'm excited to start reading it.
It's really good. I wrote a little thing in there for you.
I want to read it later.
Oh, okay. You can read that later. I mean, dating in Paris is something we can talk about at some point, too. It's single life. The nonsense that goes with that. But the analogy that I was going to say that goes with this is, I don't know if you're like this. I've been like this, and I'm really trying not to be like this anymore ever again, which is, like, there's certain things that you save because you're like, I'll do that when I find my person, like when I'm no longer single. I'm not going to go to that country, or I'm not going to go back to this place. I'm going to save this experience, this show on Netflix, whatever it is, for when I, you know, have somebody, for when I, like, have someone to share it with. And you can't wait to start living your life. Like, you got to start living your life now. And bring somebody into that whenever they come in, and they're going to hopefully add a level of richness and depth to it that otherwise wouldn't be there. But if you just sit around waiting for your life to start, what kind of life is that to lead in the first place? The second thing, I just got out of therapy and talking with her about it. Part of it is that I've been waiting for my life to start, but part of it's that I've been lost. I've been feeling pretty lost for the last few years in that sense of, like, who am I? What am I doing? Like, how did I end up doing the YouTube side of things? Like, where are these dreams and hopes going? Am I going to be able to stay in France? Just been a lot of uncertainty. And I've been waiting for, like, this safe, secure place. I've been waiting to end up in a place where I knew where I was going, what I was doing, how things were going to play out before I really started sharing the stories, and maybe even started sharing the stories from the other side rather than as I was going through them.
I actually had a video that I filmed the other day with my buddy Mark, which was a lot of fun. We bopped around Paris. The biking footage, especially with Cooper on my back, and, like, I had a lot of fun stuff. I was having fun with it, but it was also starting to feel a little bit empty. And then I got a real beatdown from my buddy Dorian, who laid into me to let me know that things were might not be heading quite the right direction, and it was exactly what I wanted to hear, if a difficult thing to hear. I ended up trashing that video because ultimately I had a lot of energy to come back to vlogging, and I'm very excited to be back to it. But just because I had energy didn't mean that I was heading the right direction. I was just heading very confidently, and I feel like something that might have been the wrong direction. Close, but not quite there. And I'm gonna figure it out. I'm gonna find it. But it's not gonna be easy. And that's just the way it is. And sometimes we're just gonna have to trash videos along the way. Sorry, it's just gonna happen, but it wasn't the right video. It wasn't the right timing.
And the reality is that I'm just gonna be lost, and I need to learn how to be lost publicly, which is a weird thing to say, but it's true. As I'm sharing these stories with you, like, I need to just walk through this, share it with you, and we'll figure it out together. I'm gonna figure this out as I go. I don't know how I'm gonna get to where I'm going. I don't even know for sure where I'm going, right? At the end of the day, I have ideas, I have plans, but those never go the way that we think they're gonna go. So being lost, not knowing for sure where I'm going, waiting to know where I'm going, has led me to leave you in the lurch, not to tell you what I'm struggling with, what I'm working on, what I'm planning on, what I'm dreaming of. And that's exactly what I wanna get back to. It's exactly what I need to get back to. And I hope you're here for it. And of course, we'll still do some Paris stuff.
Paris in My Pocket is a series that I'm not gonna let go anytime soon. I think it's a good one, but that's kind of the twofold thing. It's like, there are people find me for Paris, and hopefully they stay for me. That's always been how I've operated. That's what I've lost to some degree, and that's what I need to get back to. So on the vlogging side, let's get back to living life, like, for real, and I'll share what's going on. Projects, hopes, dreams, struggles. And then, yeah, I'll still tell you where to find a good, like, cocktail, or, like, we'll get to some French restaurants, do some croissants and baguettes. It'll all be in there. Don't you worry.